Hello everyone, am I audible? Please, anyone of you just confirm, am I audible? Am I audible? Anyone of you, please confirm.
Yes, sir.
And what about clarity? Is my voice too clear or little bit clear? Is there any disturbance? What I'm asking, is there any disturbance?
No, sir.
Okay. In the last session, this is a practical session, correct? So before starting our practical, first we have to go through some derivations, some equations, some formulae. For that purpose, what I will be doing, I will be just starting with your derivation part. Brother, means first session will be your theoretical and second session will be your practical base. Okay? There will be two sessions. Okay? Then, just need a confirmation from any one of you. Yeah, no. Don't type yes, no. Unmute yourself and say. Should we start? Should we start?
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Just interact with me. Make the section quite interactive. Then only we can study. Okay? Okay. In the last session, we have done with a half numerical only. Should I finish that numerical first? Yes, no.
Yes.
Okay. May I know that question? What was the question? May I know the question? May I know the question? Any one of you? Yes? What was the question? Any one of you, please unmute yourself and read the question once.
So the question is, find the slope of a bed of rectangular channel of width 5 meters when depth of water is...
Stop. Given. Width is equal to 5 meters. Next.
Depth of water is 2 meters.
Depth of water equals to 2 meters. D equals to 2 meters. Next.
Rate of flow is 20 meter cube per second.
Rate of flow is 20 meters cube per second. Yes.
And C is equal to 50.
And C equals to 50. Okay, this was the question, and the 2-point part was find the slope of the bed channel. Correct? This was the question, everyone. Yes, no.
Yes, sir.
This was the question.
Yes, sir.
Correct? Okay, okay. So in this question, they have asked slope of the bed channel, and the channel given over here is which type of channel? Rectangular, trapezoidal.
Rectangular.
In the question, which type of channel they have asked? Okay. Now listen here, student. I think the strength will be quite good. Okay. Listen. First of all, for instruction for your attendance. I am putting some format. In this format, you have to put your attendance. Okay. In the chat box, I have put a format. For example, you are having a UIN number, UIN 1234. Then use vertical line. There is a symbol vertical without any space. There won't be any space. Then your name without any space, put again a vertical line from your symbol box and again your roll number. Correct? In this format, I have just put, please check. Correct. Rohit Pawar has done perfectly. Yes, Rohit. In this manner, how Rohit has done without any space, in this manner, you have to put your name, roll number and UIN number in the proper sequence. And only once, no twice or thrice. In one session, only once. For another section, again once. Okay. Now listen here. Okay. We'll start with our question part. Question over here is, B is width of the channel is given, depth of the channel is given, Q is given, C is given, slope is being asked. Correct? Solution. Area of the channel. For a rectangular section, area is equal to, first we will go through the diagram part. This is the free water surface. This is the depth of the water, which is 2 meters. This is the width of the bag, which is 5 meters. Correct? And here, liquid is present, or you can say water is present. Correct? What they have been asked, what will the slope of the bed channel? Slope of the bed channel means, at what slope the river will flow, that stream will flow, that channel will flow. Correct? They are asking about the slope of the channel. Okay? Now listen here. As I told you, follow this sequence or follow this step. A, P, R, V, Q. You can follow this step and you can easily determine your answer. Correct? So if I'm talking about area, area is equal to B into D. Width of the channel is 5 and depth of the channel is 2. You will get the answer in terms of meter square. Second, perimeter. B plus twice of D. Sir, how B plus 2D? Listen here, I'm talking about wetted perimeter. I'm talking about this portion, and this portion. The portion which is in contact with the channel and water, right? The portion which is in contact with the water, that portion is known as a wetted perimeter. That formula will be B plus 2D, correct? Now, B will be 5, 2D. 2 into D, D is 2. You will get the answer in terms of meter. Perimeter is always in terms of running meter, that is meter. I'm talking about running meter. Running meter means calculating meter throughout. Next, V equals to velocity, C under root RS. So what? Velocity. This formula is derived from Chase's derivation. We will go through this derivation today itself and we will do one practical also on this. Okay? So our today's target is to derive Chase's formula and second target is to determine Chase's constant. These two things we have to do. And in the next session, in the next practical session, we'll perform practical on this online. Okay. V equals to C. C over here is 50. Okay, I have not calculated R. So first I have to calculate hydraulic main depth. So I will first calculate hydraulic main depth, which is R. R equals to A by P. Or you can say M also. Hydraulic main depth is also denoted by symbol small m. M equals to A by P. So area over here is 10 and perimeter is 9. 10 by 9. What's the answer?
1.11.
Okay, 1.11 meter. Correct? How meter? Meter square divided by meter equals to meter. Now we will calculate velocity. V equals to C under root RS. C is 50, R is 1.11, and S we don't know, correct? We don't know about S. Okay. So can you calculate 50 under root 1.11? Any one of you? 50 under root 1.11? Any one of you?
52.67.
S raised to under root. Yeah, S raised to half. Yeah, S raised to 0.5. Because if we are removing X term, variable term, from the under root part, we will get S raised to half or S raised to under root or S raised to 0.5. Correct? So 52.67, this is our velocity answer. Now, last step, Q equals to A into V. We are having Q 20 and area is 10. and velocity is 52.67 s raised to half. Using shift solve, you can easily calculate. Those who don't know shift solve, they can do 20 divided by this term and the whole raised to 2, because as per indices rule, what we have studied is standard 8. School section ki baat kar raha hu. 1 upon n is equals to raised to idhar jayega to m ho jayega, correct? 1 upon 2 here ho jata hai 2 upon 1, correct? In this portion. Barabar? Best point hai. Ya to shift solve karo, sabse best. Kya karna hai? 20 equals to 10 into 52.67 x raised to 0.5. Shift solve. Ho gaya solve. Should I do that for you? Any one of you? Sir, problem ho raha shift solve mein. Any one of you? I can do, I can present on your screen. Any one of you, please. Should I do shift solve, beta? Yes, I need a confirmation, then only I will understand.
No, sir.
Yes to yes, no to no. No, sir. Okay. Okay, okay.
बोला ना मेकअप कर कर
अरे देख
तो मेरे को नहीं दे
ये वीडियो चल बेटा ओके और भी आंसर सिंपल करने पे क्या आंसर आ रहा
है
क्या आंसर आ रहा है सिंपल करने पे
देख तो
मेरे को नहीं पता है
देखेगा तो पता चलेगा ना मैं मेरे को देखना अरे कौन
Yes. क्या आंसर आ रहा है शिफल करने पे एनी वन ऑफ यू किसी को आंसर नहीं आया अच्छा आंसर आया मेरे को
1.44 इनटू 10 रेश्यो
1.44
ओके 1.44 इनटू 10 रेश्यो माइनस 3 करेक्ट बट If you're writing your answer like this in your paper, you will definitely got zero marks. Sir, mera answer to right hai, kaisi ne diya hai. Then also you will get zero marks because whenever the question is given to you, it is not given in the form of like this. It is always given vertical is to horizontal. If you are traveling 1 kilometer horizontal, what will be the slope? If you are traveling 2000 kilometer horizontal, what will be the slope? So you have to provide this answer in terms of vertical is to horizontal. It is quite mandatory. So sir, wo answer denge kaise? Shortcut trick hai, use kar lo, you will definitely get right answer. Kya karna hai? Whatever answer you get, correct? Here I got this answer. One divide answer. You will get answer. Yes, anyone of you, kya mila answer? Any one of you?
693.53.
Okay, 693.53. Done. This is vertical is to horizontal ratio. Please note down this value. Okay, sir, can you tell again? From where, beta? This part or from the start of the numerical? You can unmute yourself and say. End part, okay. Listen here, beta. After doing shift solve, you've got the value in terms of 1.44 into 10 raised to minus 3, which is nothing but 0.00144, correct? But it is not... It is wrong to write your answer of slope in 0.000. You cannot write your answer. So how you have to write your answer? You have to write in terms of vertical is to horizontal ratio, correct? One vertical, whatever, when you are traveling 693.53 kilometers, correct? If you are traveling 693.53 kilometers, you will get a vertical distance, whatever, this vertical distance loss of 1 meter. 1 meter, whatever. For example, the river is flowing from here path A and it is traveling to path B, that slope will be quite negligible. But if you are looking for a particular distance, that slope will be quite negligible. So what you will do, you will calculate, so with the help of Chasin formula, correct? So slope equals to 1 upon 693.53. Why we are writing this? Because it is nothing but the ratio of vertical is to horizontal. Matlab ki jab main 693.53 kilometer travel karunga, correct? Sorry, meter travel karunga, because the numerical is in meter. So meter travel karunga, I will get a slope of 1 meter, which gets cancelled. That's why we are not putting unit over here. और यहाँ A से B travel करने में मुझको ये slope मिलेगा. समझ में? तो ये answer आएगा कैसे? The question arises over here. कि सर ये answer कैसे लिखना है? I am getting this answer. कुछ नहीं करना बेटा. After getting this answer, on your calci, just put click on this AC button. This AC button, correct? After clicking on AC button, press 1 divide and answer. 1 divide answer, then equals to, you will definitely get this answer, 693.53. Then write this answer in terms of 1 upon 693.53. Yes, any more queries? Put in confirmation so that I can proceed further.
No, okay, sir.
Okay, okay. Okay. Wait a second. I'm providing you third question. Please note down the third question. Please note down the third question. After completing the question, please let me know. Hope so all have done with the attendance part. Please note down the question, and after completion of question, let me know. And after completion of this question, please let me know. Done?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Take a heading, derivation. Please take a heading, derivation. Please take a heading, derivation. Okay. Done, everyone? Have you taken the heading? A fresh page and start with a heading, derivation. Should I proceed further? Should I proceed further?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. Derivation 1. Starting with your very first derivation, total there are 16 derivation in your applied hydraulics, out of which 7 derivation is being asked in your board paper. Correct? So, derivation number 1, derive Chase's formula through open channel. Derive Chase's formula through open channel. Derivation number 1, derive Chase's formula through open channel. You can write the year also. It was last asked in the year December 2018. Derive Chase's formula through an open channel. Correct? So, what is our main intention? Our main intention is to derive the Chase's formula. Correct? That Chase's term. That Chase's equation. Correct? So, why we are studying this Chase's derivation? Well, because it is not possible to determine the discharge or velocity of a running channel. So, Chase's used an equation. Chase's used his term, Chase's constant, with the help of which he has derived an equation, which equation can be used to determine the discharge through a running or a flowing open channel. Correct? So, derive Chase's formula through an open channel. So, what we will do? We will take a running channel. Correct? So, starting with the steps. Step 1, diagram. Correct? Step 1, diagram. Okay. Starting with the very first step, diagram. This is the bed slope of the channel. You can say bed of the channel. Correct? This part is bed of the channel. We will provide some slope. That slope will be negligible. Correct? This is slope I. Correct? That slope is quite negligible. Rather, minor slope is provided to the bed. Correct? Yahan pe ek slope provide kiya gaya hai end pe. Now, what we will do? We will cut this section. We will take particular section of a channel and we will start our derivation, our equation, our formula, our terms. So, what I am doing? I am cutting the section 1-1 and 2-2. Correct? One part liya section ka, second part liya. Ab koi mere ko ye mat puchna ki sir real mein cut kar rahega. It is just a derivation theoretical part. Correct? We are selecting a particular dx term. Aapko pata hoga dx term kya hota hai? जब हम लोग छोटा सा पार्ट को लेके उसके ऊपर डेरिवेशन इक्वेशंस करते हैं. करेक्ट? तो फिर अब देखो स्टूडेंट, यू कैन सी एक पार्ट से दूसरे पार्ट पे स्लोप है, बराबर. द स्लोप ओवर हियर इज आई एंड वी आर सिलेक्टिंग टू सेक्शंस 1-1 एंड 2-2. वी आर कटिंग दिस सेक्शन. करेक्ट? सो व्हाट विल हैपन? वाटर विल बी फ्लोइंग ओवर हियर, बराबर. यहाँ पे पानी फ्लो होगा, इसके अंदर से पानी जाता रहेगा. करेक्ट? इसके अंदर पानी होगा. करेक्ट? तो इसका खुद का सेल्फ वेट होगा. There will be something sulfate of the water which will be acting gravitatively downwards. Yes, no. Yes, no.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay. Anyone has studied friction chapter? Kisi ne friction chapter bahut acche se padha? Mechanics, SEM 1. Mechanics, SEM 1. Diploma walo ko bhi SEM 1 mein ya SEM 2 mein rehta rahega. Correct? Anyone of you has studied friction chapter? किसी ने पढ़ा है क्या फ्रिक्शन चैप्टर?
यस सर.
कोई ऐसा है जिसका? आई हैव नॉट स्टडीड मैकेनिक. मैकेनिक वाज स्किप्ड फॉर मी. एनीवन ऑफ यू सर नहीं पढ़ा है मैकेनिक? डायरेक्ट ना. ओके. आई एम अज्यूमिंग दैट ऑल आर फ्रॉम फर्स्ट ईयर और डायरेक्ट सेकंड ईयर. देन ऑल्सो यू हैव ऑप्ट मैकेनिक, बराबर. तो मैकेनिक का रूल क्या है? व्हेनेवर देयर इज अ फॉलिंग बॉडी फ्रॉम एन इंक्लाइंड सरफेस. Correct? So we can resolve that self weight of the body into two components, that is f of x and f of y. Correct? Yes, no. F of x and f of y. That f of x will be horizontal and f of y will be vertical, that is perpendicular to the inclined surface. Perpendicular to the inclined surface. Barabar? Ye humne padha tha. So let us resolve this component, that is self weight of the body, in x and y components. Correct? ये वर्टिकल यहाँ आ रहा है ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी, एग्जैक्टली डाउनवर्ड आएगा। मेरा बॉडी का पोस्चर कैसा भी रहने दो, ऐसा रहने दो, ऐसा रहने दो, ऐसा रहने दो, इट विल माय ग्रेविटी ऑफ द माय होल सीजी ऑफ द बॉडी विल एक्ट डाउनवर्ड, करेक्ट, एग्जैक्टली डाउनवर्ड एक्ट करेगा, करेक्ट। तो देखो ये यहाँ डाउनवर्ड एक्ट करेगा, आई विल रिजॉल्व दिस कॉम्पोनेंट इनटू हॉरिजॉन्टल एंड वर्टिकल, करेक्ट। ये परपेंडिकुलर रहेगा इसको और ये हॉरिजॉन्टल, दिस टर्म एंड दिस एंगल विल बी सेम, दिस एंगल इज नोन एज एंगल ऑफ रिपोज, मैकेनिक्स वन, करेक्ट, एंगल ऑफ रिपोज, बराबर। ये जो एंगल रहेगा स्टूडेंट वो सेम एंगल यहाँ रहेगा एज पर मैकेनिक्स रूल, बराबर। इंटीरियर एंगल से करेंगे हम लोग उसको, तो ये और ये एंगल सेम रहेगा, जिसके साथ एंगल फॉर्म होगा दैट टर्म इज ऑलवेज कॉस टर्म, एंड जिसके साथ नहीं फॉर्म होगा अपोजिट टर्म इज ऑलवेज साइन टर्म, बराबर। सेल्फ वेट ऑफ द बॉडी इज एक्टिंग डाउनवर्ड, वी हैव डन परपेंडिकुलर टू द बेड ऑफ दिस स्लोप, बराबर, W cos theta and W sin theta. Please copy this. Please copy this. Copy the diagram. Diagram अच्छे से copy करके लो.
Done, sir.
Done, sir. अच्छा, listen here, students. Last time कुछ issue हो गए थे, मुझसे ही गलती हो गई थी कि मैंने आपको instruct नहीं किया था कि the session has been completed या over, बराबर। Now last 10 minutes are remaining. If this finishes the revision, then it's okay. अगर finish नहीं होता है, तो next session exact 9:50 को start होगा। Sorry, 11:50 को next session start होगा। Please be aware of that. 11:50 उसके पहले जरूरत नहीं है ज्वाइन होने का। जैसे ही 11:50 होगा विल स्टार्ट विद आवर सेकंड सेशन एंड देन विल स्टार्ट विद आवर प्रैक्टिकल सेशन, करेक्ट। तो प्लीज नोट डाउन द टाइम 11:50, तभी स्टार्ट करना, लास्ट 10 मिनट्स आर रिमेनिंग। ओके, लिसन हियर, यू हैव फिनिश विद द स्टेप 1, नाउ विल स्टार्ट विद द स्टेप 2। स्टेप 2, ओके, वेट ऑफ द वाटर बिटवीन 1:1 एंड 2:2, weight of water between section 1:1 and 2:2, बराबर। What I am talking about? I am talking about the weight of water between section 1:1. We have cut the section 1:1 and 2:2 और इसके बीच में water present है, so what will be its weight, बराबर। मैं weight की बात कर रहा हूँ। FM1 stand 3, FM2 stand 4, we have studied one formula for weight density. Any one of you please unmute yourself and say the formula of weight density. Any one of you?
Weight upon volume.
Weight upon volume.
Ruby.
It is denoted by symbol gamma. No rho. Rho stands for mass density. Rho, mass density. Gamma. Gamma equals to weight upon volume. Correct? I am talking over here about the weight. I am not talking about weight density. I am talking about weight. Whatever. So what will be weight? Weight will be weight density into volume, बराबर। So weight will be gamma into volume. Sir, doubt आ रहा है, नहीं समझ रहा है, any one of you please, नहीं mic नहीं है, proper नहीं है, you can write in the chat box. किसी को भी doubt आ रहा है? Where gamma equals to specific weight, unit weight, weight density, तीन नाम है इसके, बराबर। किसी ने, सबने अलग अलग पढ़ा रहेगा, बराबर, हर बुक अलग अलग बोलता है, बराबर। मैं तीनों नाम बता रहा हूँ बिकॉज मुझको नहीं पता आपके पास कौन सी बुक है। वेट डेंसिटी, यूनिट वेट, स्पेसिफिक वेट, बराबर, ये तीन नाम है इसके। गामा इक्वल टू कोई भी नाम लिख दो, वेट डेंसिटी लिख देता हूं, चलो मैं वेट डेंसिटी, करेक्ट। नेक्स्ट इज वॉल्यूम, वॉल्यूम ऑफ लिक्विड या वॉल्यूम ऑफ वॉटर बिटवीन 1 एंड 2, बिटवीन सेक्शन 1 एंड 2, एंड डब्ल्यू स्टैंड फॉर वेट ऑफ द वॉटर, बराबर। मैं डब्ल्यू की बात कर रहा हूं, डब्ल्यू प्लीज क्लियर रखना वरना ओमेगा समझोगे आप लोग। चलो यू आर बी फिनिश विथ स्टेप 2, नाउ वी विल टॉक अबाउट स्टेप 3, नाउ आई विल टॉक अबाउट स्टेप 3। अब मैं स्टेप 3 की बात करूंगा, शुड आई स्टार्ट, चालू करूं स्टेप 3, यस नो,
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. I'm not erasing the diagram because I require the diagram for calculation part and for derivation also. Okay. So listen here. I'm talking about step three. Correct? May I know volume ka formula kya hota? Any one of you? वॉल्यूम का फॉर्मूला क्या होता है?
मास अपॉन डेंसिटी.
वॉल्यूम का फॉर्मूला होता है मास अपॉन डेंसिटी. चल एग्री. और दूसरा कोई फॉर्मूला इन टर्म्स ऑफ एरिया एंड लेंथ?
एरिया इनटू लेंथ. एरिया इनटू हाइट.
एरिया इनटू लेंथ.
एरिया इनटू लेंथ. हाइट नहीं बेटा, लेंथ. बराबर, लेंथ होता है. करेक्ट. तो देखो, जो स्टार्टिंग में फॉर्मूला लिखा था वेट का, वेट इज इक्वल टू, मैंने क्या लिखा था? गामा इंटू वॉल्यूम. करेक्ट, ये लिखा था. यस नो, जस्ट अभी स्टेप टू में लास्ट लाइन.
यस सर,
यही लिखा था. यस नो.
यस सर.
ओके, कैन आई रिप्लेस दिस वॉल्यूम टर्म इंटू एरिया इंटू लेंथ सिंस सिंस वॉल्यूम इज इक्वल टू ए इंटू एल. जस्टिफिकेशन भी दे दिया मैंने. मैंने कैसे रिप्लेस किया? प्लीज स्टेप टू के अंदर ही लिख के लो ये. And mark it as equation number one. Mark it as equation number one. Mark it as equation number one. Okay. Should I proceed further?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay, beta. So here we finished with step two. Pura step two achhe se complete ho gaya. Now we'll proceed further for step three. Correct? If I'm talking about step three, barabar? Agar main step three ki baat kar raha hu. Okay. So you can say direction of flow of water ya force of flow of water इन एक्स डायरेक्शन कितना हो रहा है? बराबर, फ्लो ऑफ वॉटर इन एक्स डायरेक्शन कितना हो रहा है? फोर्स ऑफ फ्लो ऑफ वॉटर इन एक्स डायरेक्शन कितना हो रहा है? एनी वन ऑफ यू, कोई भी. एनी वन ऑफ
यू, कितना
हो रहा
है?
कितना हो रहा है?
डब्ल्यू साइन है.
डब्ल्यू साइन है. करेक्ट. ओके, इज दिस अविनाश? क्या नाम है आपका?
Sir, Abid.
Amit. Okay. Student, it is quite necessary that you should interact with me. Then only you will be able to understand this subject. Okay. As I was talking about step three, flow of water in x direction. You can say force of flow of water in x direction. I am talking about forces. Barabar. So, yahan pe jo force flow ho raha hai, that is W इंटू साइन आई. मैंने जो देखा वो मैंने लिखा एज पर अबाउ इक्वेशन. इक्वेशन नंबर वन, एज पर अबाउ इक्वेशन. इक्वेशन नंबर वन, डब्ल्यू की वैल्यू मेरे पास है. यस नो. डब्ल्यू की वैल्यू है मेरे पास. यस नो.
यस
सर.
डब्ल्यू इज इक्वल टू गामा इंटू ए इंटू एल साइन आई. सर ये कहां से मिला? फ्रॉम वन मिला बेटा. फ्रॉम वन. Go to your equation number one. You will definitely get the value of W, which is gamma into A into L. Done?
Yes.
Done? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Mark this equation as equation number A. Mark this equation as equation number A. Itna likhe lo, equation number A. स्टेप फोर. बराबर, विल प्रोसीड फर्दर फॉर स्टेप फोर. अब स्टेप फोर देख के लेंगे हम लोग. अब इसकी जरूरत नहीं है बिकॉज मेरे को एक्स्ट्रा नहीं चाहिए था. स्टेप फोर. बराबर, flow of water against friction. Flow of water against friction flow, you can say whatever. Source of water against friction factor भी बोल सकते हो आप लोग. मीन्स हम लोग फ्रिक्शन फैक्टर एक टर्म लेंगे इसके अंदर, इक्वेशन के अंदर. मीन्स हम क्या बोल रहे हैं कि व्हेनेवर वाटर इज फ्लोइंग देयर इज फ्रिक्शन एक्टिंग बिलो या बीनीथ द वाटर सरफेस, बराबर. सैंड, सॉइल, ग्रेवल्स, कुछ भी है जो ऑब्स्ट्रक्ट कर रहे हैं फ्लो को, उसकी एनर्जी लॉस कर रहे हैं, बराबर. व्हेनेवर समथिंग इज फ्लोइंग देयर इज शियर फोर्स इज एक्टिंग ऑन दैट पर्टिकुलर सर्फेस, बॉटम सर्फेस पे, बराबर. तो उसमें क्या एक्ट करेगा देखते हैं. उसके अंदर एक्ट करेगा एफ स्टैंड फॉर फ्रिक्शन फैक्टर. उसके अंदर If I'm talking about flows of flow of water against friction, तो क्या क्या अपोज करके जाएगा वो, करेक्ट. तो उसके अंदर अपोज करेगा वो फ्रिक्शन फैक्टर इंटू सर्फेस, बराबर. जो भी उसके बीनीथ सर्फेस रहेगा, जितना बड़ा सर्फेस उतना ज्यादा फ्रिक्शन, करेक्ट. वाइडर द सर्फेस एरिया, वाइडर द पेरीमीटर, मोर विल बी द फ्रिक्शन, बराबर. ओपोजिशन उतना ज्यादा फ्रिक्शन रहेगा. तो सर्फेस एरिया इंटू वेलोसिटी का स्क्वायर. सर स्क्वायर क्यों? वेलोसिटी तो समझ में आया, स्पीड देखो स्टूडेंट क्या होगा. एक तो उसका स्पीड उसको अपोज करना है, साथ में जो सैंड और जो रिवर में अपोजिट वाटर रहेंगे, करेक्ट. जब वो हर्डल्स हैं, फॉर एग्जांपल यहाँ पे स्टोन ग्रेवल्स है, यहाँ पे ऐसे कुछ तो पड़े हैं, वहां पे पुट किया, यहाँ पे वापस अपोजिट आएगा, करेक्ट. ड्यू टू दिस ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन पीछे आएगा, तो उसका वेलोसिटी स्क्वायर, करेक्ट. उसके वजह से आया वेलोसिटी स्क्वायर. एक तो खुद की वेलोसिटी,